Exercise 13.1 is nothing but the revision of what you studied in lower standards. First of all, you should know the basic constructions in order to draw the constructions of 9th standard. So, exercise 13.1 is all about the revision of the previous constructions. In question number 1 of exercise 13.1, we are expected to draw a line segment AB of 10 cm and then we are supposed to construct the bisector or perpendicular bisector of line segment AB. And because of that reason, we are supposed to draw and find out the measurement of line segment AM and line segment BM. Let us see how do we draw the perpendicular bisector of a given line segment, also known as the midpoint of the given line segment. First of all, we shall draw a line segment of 10 cm length. So, this is line segment AB of 10 cm length segment. Let me tell you that you are supposed to start with 0 and end with 10. That is how you obtain the line segment. And let us call this line segment according to the question as line segment AB. I am supposed to draw perpendicular bisector of line segment AB. Over here, I will select any suitable radius, that is any arbitrary radius, which is more than half of line segment AB. That is, it is not compulsory to take any of the radius that is exactly more than half of that. You don't need to measure that. You can take randomly any radius more than half of line segment AB. Supposing I am selecting this much radius. Then, I'll draw an arc taking A as the center on the upper side and from A as the center in the lower side. I'm not going to change any radius. Once again, keeping the radius same, I'm going to take point B as the center and with the same radius, I shall intersect the previous arcs and supposing these previous arcs, they intersect each other at point X and Y or else according to the given question over here, that is point P and point Q. Now, I'll draw a line passing through point P and passing through point Q. And that line is nothing but perpendicular bisector of line segment AB. That is, line segment PQ is perpendicular bisector of line segment AB. According to the question, it intersects line segment AB at point M. As we know that line segment AB is of 10 cm, so it should be compulsory that line segment AM and line segment BM should be measuring each of 5 cm. If I put down the scale in such a way that the 0 coincides with M, then obviously 5 will coincide with A. And exactly the same way, in the reverse way, if I coincide M with 0 of the scale, then 5 will coincide with B. So, in this question, we can say that line segment AM, the measurement of that, will be same as line segment BM and that is equal to 5 cm. Exercise 13.1, question number 2. Here we are expected to draw 120 without using a protractor. That means using only a pair of compass and the straight edge, that means a scale only. We are expected to draw a ray. That is, supposing over here I am drawing a ray and let us call that ray as ray BC, where B is the initial point and that is ray BC. Using compass and any arbitrary radius, let me tell you, any arbitrary radius, I will select B as the center and any arbitrary radius, I'll draw an arc and that arc is going to be a bigger one. That arc intersects line ray BC at point say X. Then taking X as the center, I did not change the radius and taking X as the center, I'll draw another arc which intersects the previous arc. Let us call this point as point O. We are not supposed to label this point when we are supposed to construct any angle in the further figures, but over here we will label it as point O. Taking O as the center and the same radius, I did not change the radius, O as the center, I'll draw another arc, and that arc is going to intersect the original arc at say point P. We shall draw a ray AB, ray BA passing through point P. That is ray BA passing through point P. This angle is called, the measurement of this angle will be 120. Exercise 13.1, question number 3. We are expected to draw 30 degree without the help of the protractor. Same as in the previous case, we shall first of all draw a ray. Let us label the ray by some new name, that is ray QR. So this is ray QR, beginning with Q and somewhere over there, that is point R. I am expected to draw 30 degree. So first of all, the mother of all the angles, that is 60 degree. Any suitable arbitrary, any radius that you like, but remember, it should not be very big radius. We are expected to draw an arc taking Q as the center. That will intersect ray QR at some point, say point X. Now, without changing the radius, I did not change the radius, without changing the radius, I am expected to take X as the point and I'll draw an arc which intersects the original arc at point, say O. This point O is the point of 60 degree. I'm not going to draw this particular ray. Now, without actually changing the radius, taking O as the center, I'll draw an arc somewhere in between O and X. And taking X as the center, I did not change the radius, and I'll cut the original arc, and supposing that both of these arcs, they cut each other at point Y. Drawing ray QY or else ray QP passing through Y, and that is going to give us angle PQR, which will be of measure 30 degree. Exercise 13.1, question number 4. Here we are expected to draw three different angles, that is 15, 90 and 150. Now let us see how do we draw 15. It is nothing but we are expected to draw bisector of angle 30 degree. Let us see how do we draw. First of all, let us construct a ray, calling it as ray BC. Where B is the initial point and C is the point on the ray BC. Taking any arbitrary radius, taking B as the center, I shall draw an arc, and that arc will intersect ray BC at point X. Taking the same radius, I did not change the radius, remains the same. Now X as the center, I shall draw an arc which will intersect the previous arc at point, say, O. Without drawing ray BO, taking O as the center, or else you can start up with X also, I'll draw an arc somewhere in between O and X. Without changing the radius, now I'm going to take X as the center and I shall intersect the previous arc at point, say, Y. Now, I am going to draw ray BY, but that ray BY is not the required ray, because we are expected to draw a ray of 15. So, over here, I shall draw a dotted ray, and that dotted ray is of 30 degree. That is exactly half of 60. What I did was, that I constructed the bisector of 60 degree. So this is 30 degree. Now I am going to construct bisector of 30 degree, and that is going to give us, that is angle 15. I can change the radius, or I can keep the radius in the same way. Taking this point as the center, let us call that point of intersection as point P. So point P as the center, and any radius, or else keeping the radius same. I am going to take a P as the center, draw an arc, and QX as the center, and cut the previous arc. Now that arc is going to intersect each other at any point, say point Q. The ray BQ is going to give us angle of measure 15. That is, I am going to draw ray BA passing through Q, and that ray BA, so angle ABC in this case, is going to be 15 degree. Let us construct now 90 degree. 90 degree is nothing but the bisector between 60 degree and 120 degree. Let us see how do we construct 90 degree. First of all, we construct any ray, say ray YZ. That is, initial point is ray Y, and any point on that is Z. Taking any arbitrary radius, I am going to pick up Y as the center, and this radius that I have selected, it may be anything, but not very big. I am going to draw an arc, and that arc will intersect ray YZ at some point, say point P. Taking P as the center, I shall draw, that is 60 degree. Let me tell you, 60 degree, I personally call it as a mother angle, because all the angles are derived from 60 degree. This is an arc of 60 degree. Using 60 degree as a center, I'll draw another arc, and that is an arc of 120 degree. The bisector between 60 degree arc, that is this point, and 120 degree, that is this point, that is going to give us 90 degree. That means an arc taking 60 as the center, and another arc taking 120 as the center, and that is going to intersect each other at say point Q. And then I shall draw ray YQ, which will be of 90 degree of measure, and that is ray YX passing through point Q. So here angle X, Y, Z, that is the required angle of measure 90 degree. The third angle that is given over here is of 150 degree. Now 150 degree is an angle that lies somewhere between 180 and 120. What we are expected to draw is a ray, say let us call this ray as ray DE, that is D is the initial point and E is a point somewhere on ray. Taking any arbitrary radius, I shall draw an arc D as the center, and that is going to give us an arc. Now remember, over here I am going to draw an arc which is whose length will be more than that of the semicircle. This arc intersects ray DF at point say X. Taking X as the center, the angle of 60 degree. See, I told you it's a mother angle, so we require the angle of 60 degree. Taking the point of intersection of 60 degree as the center, I'll draw another arc, and that is going to give us 120 degree. And taking 120 degree arc as the center, I'm going to draw still another arc. Remember, I did not change the radius anywhere throughout this construction. Now, this is the point of 120 degree. This is the point of 180 degree. If I bisect those two points, that is the point of 120 degree, keeping the radius same, I'll draw an arc over here, and 180 degree, keeping the radius same, I draw an arc so that it intersects the original arc. And then, supposing these two arcs intersect each other at point Y, the ray that will be ray DE, which is passing through point Y, is going to be the ray of 150 degree. Let us call this ray as ray DE. So, whole of this angle is going to be 150. Let us construct some extra angles that we might require in the construction of 9th standard. That is 22.5 and 67.5. And I am going to draw them separately. 22.5 is obtained by drawing the bisector of 90 degree is going to give us 45 degree. And once again, the bisector of 45 degree and 0, that is going to give us 22.5. So, first of all, constructing the 90 degree. For that, once again, you know that the mother angle 60 degree is compulsory. So, first of all, let us draw ray BC. Taking B as a center and any arbitrary radius, I am going to draw a ray such that that ray is enough long so that I can draw an arc of 120 degree. It intersects the ray at some point. Now, I am not going to label that point. Taking the first point, I call this point as point of 0 degree. From 0 degree, we draw an arc of 60 degree. From the point of 60 degree, we draw an arc of 120 degree. Between 120 degree and 60 degree, we shall draw the perpendicular, that means we shall draw the bisector of these two. That is, from 60 degree, I shall draw the bisector and an arc, and from 120 degree, I am going to cut that arc, and that is the point of 90. I shall draw a ray, and let me tell you, this ray is going to be a dotted ray, because we are not expected to show this ray as far as 22.5 degree is concerned. Now, we shall draw the bisector of 90, that is, taking 0 as a point, or a center of the arc, and I shall draw an arc of, without changing the radius, I shall draw that arc, and taking the point of 90. Now, let me tell you that students generally make mistake that this is not the point of 90. In fact, all the points excepting the first center, whatever the angle that we have, lies on this arc only. That means this is the original center. This is the point of 0, then point of 60. If I would have drawn 30 degree, then I would have got somewhere over here. Then point of 120. So, where is point of 90? This one? No. The point of 90 is going to be this one. So, I have drawn an arc from 0, keeping the radius same, I am going to draw another arc taking 90 as a center. Now, this ray is going to give us 45 degree. But we do not require in our question as 45 degree. So, once again, this is going to be a dotted ray. So, let us draw a dotted ray. And that ray is of 45 degree. I am expected to draw now 22.5. I think 22.5 is exactly half of 45. So, taking once again 0 degree as a center and drawing the arc keeping the radius same. And now, where is the point of 45? This one? No. It is this one. And taking that as a center, keeping the radius same, and I am going to intersect this point. And that point, when joined with B, or else ray BA, when passed through this given point, it is going to give us angle of 22.5. So, this is how we draw an angle of 22.5. How do you think should we draw the angle of 67.5? If 22.5 is a bisector of 45 and 0. Then, 67.5 should be the bisector of 45 and 90. So, right up to 45, all the procedure remains same exactly as this particular angle. Let us draw a new figure. And let us call that figure by some different names. As for this particular name is angle ABC, whose measurement is 22.5. Let us draw a ray, say ray QR. What should be the measurement of the ray? Now that is a serious and idiotic question, because a ray never has a measurement because it is extending on one of the sides. So you can draw any ray, and then we are expected to draw first of all the ray of 0 degree. That is any suitable radius, and I'll draw an arc so that I can get comfortably arc up to 120. Taking 0 degree as the center, I'll draw an arc. What is that arc known as? Obviously 60 degree. Taking 60 degree as the center, further than that, and what is this arc known as? That will be obviously 120. Between 60 and 120, what is that we are going to get? Obviously 90. So 60 degree as the center, I'll draw an arc. 120 degree as the center, I'll draw another arc, and that is going to give us, if I join it with Q, then that is going to give us the arc or ray which is going to measure 90 with ray QR. That is not going to be a straight ray. I'm going to draw it as a dotted ray, because that was not the required ray. Now, taking 0 degree and 90 degree as a center, I'm going to construct 45. I'm not going to change the radius. Remember, it's not necessary to change the radius every time while drawing a construction. Taking 0 degree as the ray center, I'm drawing an arc, and now taking 90 degree as the center, let me tell you, this is not 90 degree arc. This point is the point of the 90 degree arc. And that ray is once again going to be a dotted ray. Once again, why? Because we are not going to require 45 according to the question. We require 67.5 as our question. Now, the bisector between 67.5. No, this is wrong. The bisector between 67.5 and 90. This is not 90. This is not 45. Let me tell you, this point is the point of the 45 degree. Then this point is the point of 90 degree. Taking the bisectors between them, starting with either 45 or 90. I'm going to take 45 as the first arc and then 90 as the second arc. And these two arcs are going to intersect at some point. And ray QP passing through that point is going to give us the measurement of 67.5. Because we constructed the bisector of 45 and 90. Let us construct 75 degree and 105. Now 75 degree lies somewhere between 60 and 90. Those are the reference angles. And because of that reason, I'm going to construct the bisector of 60 degree and 90 degree. And 105 must be lying between 90 and 120. So I'm going to construct the bisector of 90 and 120 for 105 degree. First of all, let us construct the bisector of 75 degree. Once again, we will require a ray, and let us call the ray as ray BC, where B is the initial point and C is any point on that ray. I'm going to construct an arc big enough, taking any suitable radius, let me tell you, that big enough so that I can get an arc of 120 degree on that. So this is how I'm going to draw that arc. That arc is going to intersect ray BC at some point, and I call that point as a point of 0 degree. From 0 degree, we get at 60 degree, the arc of 60 degree. From 60 degree point, we get an arc of 120 degree. And between 60 degree arc, that is this point, and between 120 degree, that is arc this point, we shall construct the arc of 90 degree. So this is how we get the arc of 90 degree. I'm going to draw a dotted ray. Why dotted ray? Because it is not the required ray according to the question. Whenever you draw a dotted ray, take care that it intersects the given arc at some point, so that that point is going to be the point of intersection, required intersection. Now, we are supposed to construct 75. And because of that reason, I am going to construct the bisector of 60, that is the first angle, and 90. I did not change the radius. I have kept the radius exactly the same that I have drawn. Let us see. See, it is the same radius. See, it is the same radius that I have kept as compared to the before, first construction. Now, drawing the ray from the point of 60 arc and drawing another arc from the point of 90. Let me tell you, this is not the point of 90, but this one is the point of 90. Drawing an arc, do not change the radius, and that is going to intersect at some point. Ray BA passing through that point is going to give us the measure of an angle such that this measure of an angle is going to be 75. Another angle is 105, and I will be constructing the same thing, but instead of this ray, ray BA, I will be constructing the bisector between 90 and 120. Let us see how do we construct. Let us label them something new, and that is, say, ray OD. Let us call that as ray OD, where O is the initial point and D is any point on that particular ray. I shall draw an arc taking O as the center. What radius? Any suitable radius, not very big enough, and I shall draw an arc big enough so that I can draw an arc right up to 120. Taking the point of, what is this point known as? 0. I'll draw an arc of what angle? That is 60. This point is known as the point of 60. And then I shall draw, that is the ray, that is an arc of 120. Now, between 60, that is this point, and between 120, the 60 and 120, that is this point, I am going to draw arcs which are going to intersect each other, and when I draw a dotted ray passing through O through that point, then that is going to give us 90. You know that when you draw this dotted ray, that dotted ray should intersect this arc, that is the original arc. Now, between 90 and 120, I am going to construct the bisector. Taking the center of B, this point as 90, this is not 90, let me tell you, once again reminding you, this is not the point of 90 degree. Whenever I am going to select a point for the center of 90 degree, or any center throughout the angle, that is going to be on this particular arc only. So, taking the center of 90 degree, I should draw an arc, and taking 120 degree of this point as center, I am going to draw that arc. And that arc, these two arcs are going to intersect each other, and those two arcs, I will draw a ray, say ray OG, passing through that point, and that is what is going to be angle GOD. Yes, it is very much necessary to remember this, but angle GOD, that is going to be 105.